Coming up next, it's a bantamweight clash between Aljamain Sterling and TJ Dillashaw.
You ready?
Well, these guys have been on each other's radars for quite some time. Quick entry to get in on a single.
That was a great single. Oh, takes it for the right. What a fantastic takedown.
Well, you know, I don't like the gi very much, but I have an appreciation and a healthy one for these type of transitions.
You can tell he's been in a gi at some point in his life with the way that he moves so freely.
I'm skipping jiu-jitsu next week, too. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
Sterling's right back to the full mount. Using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's now trying to isolate an arm.
Yeah, he's trying to go to a Kimura lock right here. He'll either try to get the submission or use the sweep. The Kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
Posturing up now, and he's out.
He jumps on a headlock. We call this in wrestling just a headlock. And if you're not careful, you can get stuck in an arm triangle. Watch triangle.
Up there, then he's out. Nicely done there as he forces the miss from his opponent.
Keep working it. Give me those elbows.
60 seconds now to go in the fight.
Now, the guy's attacking the triangle. He finds himself in trouble because he got a little bit lazy in the full guard.
Looks like he's trying to manipulate the head. This could be tight.
Watch triangle. There he is. He's moving to the finishing position. Now watch him.
Nicely done. Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Now trying to hip escape. Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. How about this fight, folks? You see, he was nearly caught in a submission there right at the end of the round. Saved by the bell. So back to the stool. Mentally probably not in a great place here. We'll see if...
This round, we want to keep mixing things up. Use your punches, use your knees.
All right, here we go with round two, Aljamain Sterling versus TJ Dillashaw. Oh, beautiful jab there. It's one thing to have length, of course, it's another to use it effectively. Beautiful job with that jab.
That was looking nice strike.
And they separate. Sterling comfortable wherever the fight goes, but you're seeing a lot of the improvements he's made in his stand-up under Ray Longo, and at least early on in this one, more than content to strike.
Big punch in the clinch.
Well, he continues to stay busy, and he continues to land with volume punches here.
I mean, volume, but he's not wasting anything. He's so accurate out there.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Aljamain Sterling. And connecting with 48% accuracy against TJ Dillashaw. That's hard to do.
Well, he has landed some good shots, DC, but really unable to string anything together in terms of solid combat.
Oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's going to break him?
Good movement by him here, transitioning very well on the ground tonight.
Step for step, he's staying with his opponent in every transition. Now it's his mount.
Oh, he gives up his back here, DC. That's something that you almost never would do.
No, you got to try not to give up your back, especially on a guy that's this good with the top control from the back position. No one just has that many rear naked choke victories without a great understanding of the position. He has to understand this, and he believes that he's the best back taker in the entire world,
right.
And he has an opportunity right now to show that. Now he's on top of him looking for the finish.
Oh, and now we'll snap the head back. The referee has seen enough.
Mercifully,
winner by TKO.
He mercifully stopped the fight. A great stoppage and a great performance by this young man.
Get you some replays now. Certainly a lot for our replay guys to.
We send it inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer.